Namaskaram friends. So in this video I am going to talk about water, because nowadays there is a flood like situation in many parts of India. So I want to talk about on this topic because many people faces this problem in terms of disaster management. Many people faces this problem like flood, tsunami, drought, volcanoes. All these things are nature phenomena which people do not understand and go into the problem of the nature. So clearly not about particularly about water, but particularly about flood. So when we look at the planet Earth, we know that 5 oceans and 7 continents, and these 5 oceans are a big dump of water bodies. Okay, then ocean are a bigger water bodies, then rivers, then lake, then pond, then spring, then waterfall. All these things are a form of a water bodies. Okay, so water and land is very systematically distributed on the planet Earth. Okay, and when river find its course, we have to understand its length, its catchment area, and we do not have to build any building or any infrastructure or any human settlement in that area, because it is a course of water. Even for 10 to 5 years this course is abandoned for few times, but after that river again find its path and move on to that course. This is same with the ocean, this is same with the pond, this is same with the spring. If we cover the pond, it is not like a situation, but when more rain come, then that rain is not absorbed by the pond, then it spread in the whole city, in the whole village, and it create a havoc. Okay, so we have to understand the nature, understand the distribution of water, understand the importance of different types of water bodies, and apply our idea in that field so that we are not facing the problem of natural disaster. We are not suffering with these types of problem, because when we see news in the television, we are very like anxiety like situation come in our mind, because many people suffer. Houses are damaged, infrastructure are damaged, many even life of people is gone, property is gone. So and what is our task? Our task is to solve the problem of the human being, and this is the biggest problem. Okay, see, when problem is created by the human being, it is a much worse than it is happening by its own. Okay, because we know that in nature many things are happened by its own, like air is blowing, different types of activities happening in the space, happening within the surface of the core, happening in the life of a plant, life of an animal, happening in terms of element, happening in terms of inanimate and animate objects. But if we disturb the natural course, or if we disturb the natural path of a nature, then it creates a havoc in our life. Okay, for example, in terms of this, in this video we are clearly focused on a flood. Okay, so let's when we look at a map, there are, let's say, thousands of rivers flowing in the whole continent. Okay, in India alone, I think small to bigger river, more than 500 rivers are flowing. Okay, so when you disturb the course of a river, when you build infrastructure, when you build building, when you build hotel, or when you build buildings for tourism purpose, that means you disturb the course of nature. Understand the course of nature and build your infrastructure according to that area. If that region is a hilly area, do not build infrastructure. Provide tools, technology and methods which people reach to the point by their own. Okay, or even if there is if some places are not for human being, so just left that place as in its real form, in its natural form. Do not disturb that. Okay, because we know very minuscule about nature, we know very minuscule about creation, and when we disturb the creation, when we disturb the activity of the creation, it fire back in our activity. Okay, so for example, let's say if we understand the course of the nature, we understand the course of the water bodies, and we do not bring settlement, so that flood, that like situation are like a scenery for us. We see the flowing of water, large amount of water flowing from this side to that side, different activities are of nature is going on. Okay, different trees are absorbing the water, different animals are feeding, different animals are, you can say, saving their habitat or living in their habitat. The region which are, you can say, very lack of water, that region is, you can say, entrenched or you can say enriched by the water. So whatever natural activity going on in the creation is for the benefit of the all the life form, but human being disturb this activity, and through this not only human being, plant, animal and other life form is also suffer. So it is the our responsibility to understand the issue, understand the natural phenomena and do accordingly, so that not only human being but other life form are not suffer. Okay, see, different, we have 193 UN recognized country. Each and every country have their own policy and program to tackle with the disaster management. Okay, but the most important thing is we have to make policy in such a state that people who encroach that area, or you can say businessmen who encroach that area, or mafia who encroach that area, we have to make policy and program so that we aware that people who are encroach that area, or you can say make a stringent provision regarding that, so that people do not encroach that area, and people another life form not going to suffer in the future, because for their profit, for their short term profit, they disturb the long term well being of the humanity, long term well being of the life form. So it is the responsibility of each and every government, let's say central government, state government, local government, as well as on the international forum, international different bodies, NGOs, stakeholders, to come together, take a region, start a pilot project on that region and solve this problem. Let's say on a flood, if many geology scientists, if scientists related to geology, related to geography, related to space, science and technology come together and they make a policy and program that through science and technology they launch a satellite in the space, that satellite gather a data regarding that region, people on the ground understand that data and you can say collect different information related to that, then scientists understand the soil, moisture of soil, types of soil, types of region, topography of the region, and then make a policy and program, and it is the responsibility of the state government to implement that policy, because this is the very, very natural disaster as the most important, you can say, problem in the world, because we created it. We created it, and it is our responsibility to solve it. Naturally, what is happening is going to happen, so we do not have to disturb the part. And many of things we do not know, but we predict something. So on the basis of that, we have to make a policy and program so that we, you can say, less number of life and property is going to loss in the future flood or disaster like situation. Okay, so if let's say all government, not all, if the maximum majority of the government of the world come together, make a policy and program and identify the region which is the hot spot for these types of activity, and according to that region make policy and program and implement that policy on a grassroots level in a very efficient manner, then people suffer from other problem, but not through this problem, and this is the biggest problem. Other problem we can solve through other policy and program and other debate and discussion, but first of all natural disaster problem are the most havoc, okay, in any part of the world, in USA, in China, in India, in Brazil, everywhere where you can say nature play a dominant role, or topography of that region is such that if we disturb a small portion of that, it create a havoc for the whole region. So we have to identify not only flood, for drought, for volcano, for let's say cyclone, tsunami, for all this we have to make a team which are focused on all this issue, because we economic situation is disturbed, life of people is disturbed, property is disturbed, we do not focus on other activity which is very important in our life. If we are not focusing on it, large amount of money is spent on rehabilitation, providing them shelter homes, providing them medicine, providing them food. If this is reduced on a much larger scale, then we invest our time on money or other project which is very important for the human being, because as a human being we have the most sophisticated mind, so we have to understand the problem, solve the problem from its root, not only from one part of the world but from all part of the world, because if any part of the world suffer from this problem, other may think is not their concern, but in future, in a long term, that problem again occur in that region, not naturally but through other way. Let's say in India, for example let's say in India many people have suffered from this problem, and let's say this types of infrastructure is not going to build in the future in that region, so maybe that people migrated into other countries, so it become a problem that country, because migration policy is rectified by many country in the UN. So it not in terms of flood only, but in terms of disaster, in terms of drought, in terms of tsunami, in terms of volcano. We know that many a cases when fight is going on between one army and another, many migrants are going from one region to another region. So if problem is occurring in any part of the world, it is concern for the whole world. Okay, because in long term they faces the problem, not in the short term but in long term. So we have to solve the problem understand the problem from its deep, solve the problem in a very comprehensive manner so that no people of the world is suffering from that problem. Okay, and we identify the hotspot area of flood, hotspot of area where nature play a dominant role. Okay, and we have to respect the nature because we are dependent on the nature. Our life is dependent on the nature in terms of air, in terms of food, in terms of infrastructure, in terms of our day-to-day luxurious life. Everything is dependent on the nature. If we destroy the nature, we are destroying us in a installment. Okay. And its result is shown in a long term. Okay, so we have to understand the most important idea which has come out from this discussion is we have to understand the nature. Each and every human being have to aware about their region, their situation, or what types of problem is occurring in their region. And government from different countries come together, make a policy and program. Let's say if a flood like situation is occurring in more prominently in 20 to 30 countries, so we do not have to we do not have to raise that issue on UN, or we do not have to take countries of all the country altogether. We have to just make a forum of 20-30 countries which are very most severely affected by that region and make a policy and program and take help of the other organization like World Bank, IMF, UN and other regional and local organizations so that hotspot area is solved. Later on we implement policy in other small area, but first we have to solve the severe problem, then smaller. Okay, so in India we in the news we see Delhi, Himachal, Uttarakhand, many hilly areas are very much suffering from the flood. Life is destroyed, property is destroyed, many infrastructure is destroyed. Through this we not only life, property, but time is also destroyed because people who are going to work in the office, they are not done, so economic activities hamper. Okay, we do not run other program because that region is flooded, so that one life is, property is, people who do things not just by stucking in the protecting their property, their life, so in that term also we lost a quite amount of time just by saving the people, just by saving the infrastructure. So if we earlier done that, lots amount of money, lots amount of time, lots amount of human resources are protected, and we create a better society, better humanity, and as well as better life of the human being in that region. So it is the responsibility of the all world to come together, solve the problem of each and every part of the region so that any region if suffer from any problem, they consider their problem and resolve it in as good manner as possible. So if state government are suffering from that issue, so it is the responsibility of central government to release fund as well as provide infrastructure, provide support of NDRF, SDRF and try to resolve each and every issue as soon as possible. Natural disaster is not in our hand, but what types of knowledge we have till now, try to apply that knowledge so that we have to save the people. And in future it is our responsibility, it is our concern that these types of activity do not repeat again. We have to form a commission committee so that they look after this type of situation, because in Delhi, Himachal, in hilly areas, this type of situation is occurring very similar each and every year. This types of problem maker, that means state government, local government, central government is not taking the responsibility, taking the responsibility of resolving this issue. Just make a poll promises, just make a promises to this and they are not doing this. No, if we have to make any program, any policy for the betterment of the human, we have to implement that policy irrespective of whichever party you follow, whichever types of religion you follow, whichever types of gender you are. No, here gender, religion, race, caste, sex, party doesn't work. Here the main concern is save the life of the human being, save the infrastructure so that future generation not suffer a lot, because through flood that types many activities are halted for let's say 15 to 20 days. So we are losing not just money but time of the 20 days in which we can create a many good things, many prosperous things and many conscious things for the solving other problem. okay, because this problem are neglected. Earlier this problem is sorted out, but due to the negligence of the political party, these issues are not resolved. So it is the fault of the political party, it is the fault of the human being, it is fault of the businessman, encroachment people, that they are ignoring the call of the nature, and due to their due to their lawlessness, other people who are innocent are suffering. So I hope you understand the problem of the flood and try to solve the problem of natural disaster by understanding the nature, as well as aware each and every human being to raise question to your leader, so that they raise this question in the parliament, in the assembly, and that issues are solved as soon as possible in whichever region they are. All the people from all the region must raise concern regarding that. Let's say if problem is occurring in Delhi, so it is not only responsibility of the people of Delhi. It is the main responsibility of the people of Delhi, but it is also responsibility of the other people who are living in different parts of the world, different parts of the state, to raise that issue. Why state government are lacking? Maybe people of that region is not so much vocal, or maybe they are, you can say, doing different tasks, not aware of it. It is their loss, because whatever you do, you have to raise concern regarding that. Other people raise it, but its impact is not as potential as your impact is, because you are living in that region. Okay, so it is responsibility each and every human being to raise that issue, and aware each and every human being to solve this problem as soon as possible, because political parties are also human being. Their negligence, if we play a blame game, it is not beneficial for anyone. So first of all, we have to resolve this issue. When that issue is resolved, later on we make policy program and debate, discussion, and you can say do debate and discussion on that issue, so that these types of problems not occurring in the future, not occurring in any part of the world, not occurring in any part of the region. Okay, so it is responsible to human being first solve the issue, then later on discussion, debate on that issue, so that these types of problem is not occurring in the future and not occurring in any part of the world. So I hope you love this video, you enjoy this video, and gain some perspective, some knowledge out of it. So namaskaram, thank you.